We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Star Trek The Q Conflict, Issue 6. This is the final part of the IDW miniseries from 2019, written by Scott Tipton and David Tipton, pencils by David Messina, inks by Elisabetta D'Amico, colors by Alessandra Alexakis, art assist by Gregory Spalletta, lettering by Neil Uyetake. Yeah, I'm gonna butcher all these names. Editorial assist by Annie Perhentupa, edits by Chase Moritz, group editor Denton J. Tipton. Picard and the other captains meet with three new allies, one of which is Amanda, who is a Q, and two others that are ridiculous. So these three MacGuffins show up to help out and supply an unlikely assist. And while Q sets out to have the teams do something completely insane, the captains and all the people that are involved arm up and go through a portal that they construct using two of their MacGuffin characters and that strange device that Janeway won in one of the other issues. Well, Q is very unhappy with this and attacks them, and we get to see some of the characters fighting around, that sort of thing. And eventually it is very obvious that things are going a little south for Q. That of course leads to intervention. Things get resolved in a strange way, but an interesting story for sure. The concept I thought for this issue was really good. This issue was better than the last one. I thought the art is definitely rough around the edges, but some of this one was definitely better than previous issues. I have a hard time recommending this story because the miniseries itself has a lot of problems. It suffers from way too many characters being in here, and a lot of them don't even get any real time, so you don't see their personalities or anything like that. And it's assumed you've seen all of the shows at least several times, or at least several key episodes, I should say. Otherwise, it looks like they're just making stuff up, especially like knowing who Amanda is, knowing secrets about Dr. Bashir, things like that. Odo. Quark doesn't really do anything anyway. There's a lot of characters that we barely see through this miniseries that were only in there to try and lure fans in. I maintain that they should have taken 5 or 6 characters for 2 different ships and done it that way. They could have taken characters from all the shows and just put them on 2 ships and gone with that. That would have been an easier premise instead of having 4 ships with like 8 people each. There's not enough screen time for all of them, to use a TV expression. That was the primary fault with this story. Otherwise, the general concept was fine. I thought it had some really great potential. I just think it fell a little short. This issue was pretty good. We saw some interesting stuff that I actually liked. The new weapons that were introduced were kind of cool, and how they defeated Q was interesting, but overall, I think you had to have seen a whole lot of different episodes of all of the different series to really understand what was happening in this miniseries. So this was really just for diehard fans, and the art really hurt the book, because overall, probably half of the issues were horribly drawn. But overall, it was okay. If you find it in a 50-cent box, yeah, pick it up then, but you're going to have to pick up every issue. Otherwise, it's not going to make a whole lot of sense, and you're really not going to get the most out of it. There were just too many flaws in this storyline for me to recommend it, and you had to have seen a whole lot of Star Trek for most of it to make sense. If you're just an average person who's only passingly familiar with Star Trek, you're not going to enjoy this. It's going to be confusing, and it's going to look contrived. So I would say, if you're not a diehard fan, definitely pass on this. If you are a diehard fan and you love Star Trek, pick it up for really, really cheap. So otherwise, I'm not going to recommend it. You have to be a diehard to really get the most out of this. That's just my take on it. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the About page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.